You know about breathalyzers to catch people driving under the influence? Well, now get ready for a breathalyzer to find people infected with COVID-19. Thanks for staying with us. I'm Evan Forrester. Fox 43's Jamie Bittner with the technology that could soon become a reality from the same people who are also debuting a marijuana breathalyzer this year.
It looks like the typical traffic stop, but it's far from it. This breathalyzer you're seeing is meant to detect marijuana, not alcohol. And soon that same brand of technology could be used to capture COVID-19.
Howe Labs created the COVID-19 breathalyzer based on the same exquisitely sensitive technology platform that we use for the Hound marijuana breathalyzer, which is coming to market later this year.
Dr. Mike Lynn is the CEO of Hound Labs, the company that Fox 43 first introduced you to back when their focus was on marijuana. Now it's time for a new project, and the pandemic is the place to start.
This is the very beginning of research.
This is a typical breathalyzer police use every day to catch drunk drivers in our area. The COVID-19 breathalyzer would work the same way.
And it says blow.
Blowing in it and getting instant results. But detecting a virus is much harder than detecting alcohol or even marijuana.
One of the difficult pieces is actually detecting, grabbing that virus from the breath, because there's like 500 other things in each time you breathe.
So they're starting with a small study and are planning a clinical trial.
We've tested about 85 people or so with known COVID-19. And the way we do it is we do a nasal swab and a breath sample at the same time,
with the goal to make the COVID-19 breathalyzer ultimately just as instantaneous as their new marijuana breathalyzer. And the alcohol breathalyzer is already on the market, and it will have many potential uses.
Perhaps using it at ballparks or in airports or in schools.
And Lynn says that technology could open the door to detect other viruses in the future, like pneumonia. But as far as COVID-19, it's a start to stopping potential super spreaders in their tracks.
If it's in your breath, you're much more likely to be a super spreader. And those are the folks that we want to focus all of our attention on.
Jamie Bittner, Fox 43 News.